Hey, assistant coach, how are you guys doing? It's me, Johnny Sports, with the room in green, because today your boy is rebuilding Werder Bremen. Back in the day when I was younger, when I was around like 10, 12 years old, whatever, this team was actually on fire. Werder Bremen used to be a very good club in Germany, and somehow they have lost their way and they are now stuck in the second Bundesliga, which is a disgrace, just like Schalke. It's just a madness to see these big clubs from back in the day now down there. It's just not right. Because of that, today we're going to be rebuilding Werder Bremen, and I will base it off of, or somehow take inspiration off of, their team from back in the day. There are two players that I personally want to have their replacements off in this team. First of all, Miku. Back in the day, for Werder Bremen, he was an incredible, world-class tight midfielder, in my opinion. And then Ailton, who scored 28 goals in the Bundesliga when they won the league title. You can see the coach himself is named Ailton. Ailton was a Brazilian striker that was small but kind of stocky. And he was just, I don't know, he had something about him that people couldn't just get a hold of. People could not understand how this guy was so good back in the day. So Ailton and Miku, those types of players I will try and replicate in this Werder Bremen rebuild, and hopefully we'll have some fun. If you're excited about this one, make sure to smash that like button. Let's see how long it will take us to take Werder Bremen to the top of world football. And let me know in the comments down below, who is the best football player that played in the Bundesliga that you have watched and that you became a huge fan of? Because I feel like everyone has like one or two players from different leagues. Even though they don't necessarily watch those leagues, they have certain players that they remember. Let me know in the comments down below. That'd be much appreciated. For me, when I think of Werder Bremen, I personally also think of Diego. Diego was insane. Brazilian center attacking midfielder. He was unbelievable. And then he went to like Atletico Madrid and his career kind of went downhill. Nothing really happened. So that's mine. Let me know yours in the comments down below. And of course, hit that like button. Subscribe if you're new. Let's get it. And green room is ready. I'm ready. Let's do this. When you look at the starting lineup of this squad, you can kind of tell that things are not necessarily perfect over here. There are a couple of issues with this squad, but for a second Bundesliga team, it's not the worst. We have the likes of Ömer Toprak being the captain of this team with Veljkovic alongside him. Veljkovic. Or what is it? Veljkovic? I don't even know, bro. Why am I even trying? Anyways, Weiser plays down the right back spot. Used to be a huge, huge talent in FIFA, and now no one really remembers him. Dinci is one of our biggest talents in the squad, so hopefully we can get him moving forward in terms of his rating. And of course, having Pavlenka is going to be a big plus. We have a 29-year-old goalkeeper that is actually very capable of being in this squad for a very, very long time. But decisions will have to be made. Bittencourt, Füllkrug are some of the top players in the team as well. He's 27, he's 28. Obviously, these rebuilds, it's not about just going ahead and bringing in youngsters. We can also bring in established players into the squad. I can immediately tell that that partnership that we have in that CDM spot is god-awful. So we will have to focus on that one straight away and possibly bring in someone to play right wing as well. But we'll see how that goes, because with the right wing to left wing development plan, we could possibly get Dinci to like a 70 this season. And it would be kind of a shame to take that potential away from him. So we'll see what happens. But this is the squad that we have right now. Another talent that we have is Agu, by the way. And I think I'm going to rather play him than play Weiser. Weiser is going to be sold, and we'll see how things go. I'm excited for this rebuild. Let's get it started, guys. The first season, we are going to be having around, what is it? We will have around 9 million euros to spend. Now, again, as I mentioned before, what I want to build over here is a team that kind of reminisces the squad that Werder Bremen had back in the day. In the year 2003-2004, that's the season, they had certain players doing incredible jobs. Miku, as a center attacking midfielder, had 10 goals and multiple assists, of course. And the top scorers in that team used to be Klasnic, the Croatian striker with 13 goals. But then, of course, it was Ailton that was rocking the show with 28 goals. And we'll try and bring in certain players from those nationalities and put them into the right positions. But the striker position and the center attacking midfield spot are definitely on lockdown. We know exactly what type of players we want to bring in there. But first of all, let's rebuild this team to get back into the Bundesliga. I have gone ahead and made a couple of transfers, but here's something shocking. I didn't realize this. Whoa, voice break. I didn't realize this was even possible. But in the Youth Academy, we have a 72 rated Daniel Hoffman, who is looking incredible. And he could immediately go into the starting lineup, which I will do. Daniel Hoffman, as the German striker, is going to take over for now. And then once he goes up in his rating, we can then sell him on and then bring in the likes of Ailton into the squad. So that's going to be the plan. But for now, that right there is probably one of the highest rated players I've ever had come through the Youth Academy at the beginning of a rebuild or a career mode video in general. Füllkrug, yes, you're higher rated and all that good stuff, but I gotta let you go. Hoffman takes over right there. Ooh, he's actually better. Ooh, hold on. Is he better at camp? Oh, he goes up to a 75 over there. Well, that's interesting. 75 in the camp spot. You know what? Might have to replace Bittencourt then. All right, hold on. Füllkrug, you're back into the mix. Hoffman comes in as a 75 rated center attacking midfielder, which is the exact same rating as Bittencourt, which means we can just sell him on. This man is going to play, and we're going to keep him for now until we bring in the French center attacking midfielder to take over in that spot. But also, your boy has gone ahead and brought in Ayala. I brought in two Argentinian CDMs. I wanted players to come in here and basically have that Southern South America mentality. A lot of those dudes in the CDM spots there are really, really tough lads. So I want to bring them into this spot. And hopefully we can have two absolute destroyers in the midfield there in Ayala and Varela. I will show you guys how much I spent on them as well. As a left back, I brought in Paulinho, who doesn't know if he should be smiling or not in his picture. Nonetheless, 26 years old, 5'10" tall, has really good pace. And we're going to work on his defending. And then on the right-hand side, we still have Agu, but another one ahead of him, Zakarian. This kid in real life right now is one of the hottest talents out there. The Russian league currently is not playing. I do wonder if someone is going to go out there and buy this guy, because he is very talented and he doesn't have a picture yet. But trust me, Zakarian is going to be a name that you're going to hear in the future very, very often. Kid's a beast. So we signed him as well. Let me show you how much we have spent. We now have only 1.13 million left, which is obviously not a lot of money, but we have done the deals that we wanted to make. So here you go. Veljkovic plus 2 million for Zakarian. He has come in there. Paulinho costs us 4.5 million. Varela 1.2 plus Rapp, who was the CDM that was there already. Ayala has gone over for 950k, or come in for 950k, and Jung. And that is it. The first transfer window for Werder Bremen is finished for now, unless we get some massive offers for Füllkrug and also for Bittencourt. If that happens, I'll go ahead and use the money from both of them lads to go ahead and sign a Brazilian striker. We have sold a bunch of players, and the Brazilian to lead the line and become the new Ailton is going to be Evan Ilson. Now, here's the deal. There is no one really that would basically be like Ailton. I mean, in terms of like play style, I guess you could say maybe someone like a Gabriel Jesus, but then again, not really. It's such a weird one, but I'm going to go ahead and bank my money on Evan Nilsson, because obviously we don't have insane amounts of money. 8.5 million paid for him. Actually, 8 million paid for him, including our former striker here who we had on the bench. So Evan Nilsson goes up top. The Brazilian is locked down in that striker position, which means now we will just see what we can achieve with this squad for the first season. No more spendings. Let's get it started. The first season is coming to an end, and Werder Bremen is doing a good job. Obviously, as expected, this squad should be doing well, especially with the high-rated goalkeeper in Pavlenka. You expect the team to be successful. The defense is actually really, really solid, and at this point, I'm hoping to see some massive growth. In order to achieve some sort of greatness in our first season in the Bundesliga, we will need a couple of players close to the 80 rating. So let's take a look at it. First season is over, and Werder Bremen is first. Come on, right ahead of Schalke and Hamburg, which is lovely. Hopefully, all three of them can go up into the Bundesliga. That would be an amazing thing to see. Three Bundesliga giants coming back in would be nice to see. There are a couple of teams in the Bundesliga at the moment that I personally have zero care for, like the likes of Union Berlin and stuff, but they're actually doing well. So, hey, you know what? They're making their names right now. Anyways, Werder Bremen, first place at the moment, and We have Zakarian at an 80. We have Hoffman at a 79. We're going to be replacing him with a French lad. That's going to be fun. As I said, Dinkchi is going to grow a lot. 64 to 69. Lovely to see that. Schmidt has done well here. He's only like 22 years old. Hey, Schmidt, I see you. I see you, buddy. Evan Nilsson, 76 rated. He came in at a 74, if I'm not mistaken. And both of these lads were below 70. I'm pretty sure of that. 69 and 68, I think they were. And they have grown nicely here. Friedel has gone up. Okay, that's cool. He was like a 73. Toprak has done well this season, it seems. Agu has gone up massively. And the same goes for Paulinho. But Agu has gone up by like plus 6, if I'm not mistaken. So very, very good season right here, guys. And overall, can't complain. One thing, though, that I didn't mention when we started off was, and we have a bunch of players going out. Like, we have a bunch of players that we loaned away, like loaned out, right? But also, we have a bunch of players that are loaned into our team. Like, someone like this Lucas Mai kid here, who is supposed to be a talent. Asala is going to leave us as well. And I think Mitchell Weiser was a loan as well, which I didn't realize. So, Mitchell Weiser is going to leave the squad as well. Good thing is we have already replaced him in a starting lineup, so no issues there. Goals wise, Zakarian 21, Evan Nilsson 13-2. Okay, he's not quite Ailton yet. 28 goals necessary for him to pull that off. Paulinho, the left back, has had a great season right there, and Mitchell Weiser has probably played a lot of games because of his rating. But Agu took over later on. You can see that in terms of the matches played for them, lads. So let's get it on. First season in the Bundesliga. Here we come. Werder Bremen is back. The new season in the Bundesliga now. I'm kind of hyped about this. Also, you know what, guys? I love recording these types of videos, especially when we finally get to use the team at the end. It's like so nice to get the feel of these players at the height of their potential, because sometimes you will have like a 90 rated player and he'll feel trash, while an 85 rated player that you have in your team, which happens very, very randomly at times, plays like a god. So yeah, I'm excited about that, but let's see what we can build right here. We have Evan Nilsson at the 76 to begin with this season, Hoffman at the 80. We can sell him on for big, big money. Talking about big money, the promotion gave us 28 million, which is already an amazing amount, but I am ready to go crazy. It's time to let go the highest rated player in our team. I'm going to sell him, and I'm going to use that money to build a strong team in the Bundesliga, because with this team that we have right now, we are going to get smacked up to pieces. I do not want to see that. So let's start working on it. Hoffman, you will help us a lot with the money. So let's see if we can get a deal done as soon as possible. A deal of 68 million has just been signed with Sevilla. Yes, guys, that is the amount that we're going to be getting for Daniel Hoffman. It's not necessarily ideal. I was kind of hoping for more, but I can use that to our advantage here. We will deal with that in a second. Paulinho ain't going nowhere. He's 27 though, but I will still trust him for this Bundesliga season. And now, after selling him, I need to buy maybe 4 to 5 players. Let's get this started, boys. This is going to be the fun part. A French center attacking midfielder first. The Miku of this team has to come in. I have just made that transfer happen, and the money from Hoffman has not even come in yet. So the transfer we have gone for is Ludovic Blas. He is a Frenchman playing for Nantes, a very talented player, now 24 years old. 28 million we had to pay for him, which was basically our entire budget, but he's going to be taking over exactly that cam spot for us now. Hoffman, I appreciate your service, but this man is going to be our very own Miku. Left-footed, 79 pace, 76 shooting, 77 passing, 82 dribbling. A player that can basically do anything and has some decent physicality to himself as well, along with the four-star skills. I am very excited to have him in that spot. He's only 24 years old, still has some upside to himself. So Ailton and also Miku's replacement are in now in this squad. And with the rest of the money that we get, you know what? I might even buy 2 new CDMs, because the rest of the team is actually looking pretty decent right now. So we'll see what happens there. I am about to sign the second player, the second midfielder into our team, and his name is Thuram. I couldn't resist. I mean, if your name is Thuram, I just got to go ahead and get you. I still remember Thuram from back in the day. I think his name was Lilian Thuram, if I'm not mistaken. And I think he has two sons who play football. Is this the other one? Let me just quickly check. Now I really want to know, because I think this could be quite interesting information for you guys as well. Lilian Thuram, son. So yeah, there we go. Who are his... Hey, this one is actually his son. Haha, let's go. I didn't know. Oh, let's go. I know that the one from Gladbach, the Marcus Thuram, is his son. I didn't know this one was as well. Man, the guy has great genes, huh? Wow, GGs. He has two sons playing professional football. That's incredible. We're going to go ahead and bring in Kefren Thuram into the squad. 23.5 in his wages. And that basically is our entire budget used up now, guys. He comes in as a CDM, 76 rated, 16 million. We paid much more for a different player. Let me show you who that was. That player is Fehrmann, who has just recently gotten a move to, I believe, PSV Eindhoven, where he's going to be playing alongside one of the most talented players and outstanding players right now in Europe, which is Sangare. Sangare is having a great time as a CDM there, and now he's going to be getting Fehrmann next to him, who's actually very good. So I really wonder how good that midfield is going to be moving forward. But lads, here it is. Varela, I'm sorry, pal. You're going to be dropped. And Fehrmann comes in as a right center midfielder, right? Oh, no, he's going to go on to the left, actually. Left center midfielder for him, right? And then Thuram is just going to be the CDM. This is the setup now for this season. I have a lot of faith into this, but I also have to let you know, Toprak is retiring at the end of the year, so we got to be careful with that. A new center back will have to come in at some point. If I can sell him now, I'll do so, which I don't think it's going to be possible because he's retiring, so that was a silly thing to say. But yeah, we will have to see how we deal with that situation. Our bench is a mess for the Bundesliga, but the starting lineup is good enough. The new lads are in. Let's see what we can achieve in the first Bundesliga season. I'm going to say we're going to get like maybe 10th as the maximum. Good luck to us. The season is coming to an end, and you can see wins against Köln and Schalke and Stuttgart and Leipzig, but a loss against Dortmund. Are we doing this well? Only one loss in all those games. Wow. Okay. Now this gives me hope. Werder Bremen, are you better than 10th position? Whoa! Top four! No freaking way! How did... What? I'm genuinely confused. How did that even happen? Toprak, the captain, retiring at the end of the season. Has he done a madness? Has he led this team to an incredible season? Yes, he has. 61 points ahead of Dortmund, Leverkusen, Hoffenheim, Gladbach. All those teams looking at Werder Bremen right now and thinking, what's going on over here? This team was supposed to be in the second Bundesliga. Why are they up here destroying us, taking away the Champions League spots? Lads, I think we still have to qualify for Champions League. I think that's a qualification spot. So technically, we could be in the Europa League. But look at the team. Zakarian, 87. This kid is on fire. Next season, I need to bring in someone new to play left wing. And we're going to go ahead and improve that person a lot. Oh, I never changed Zakarian's position. I just realized. Sorry about that. Bang, he's a right wing. Now we're going to train him to become a left wing. He has been playing on that right-hand side without the position all this time. But man, is that impressive. Plus 6 growth for him. Just generally speaking, the squad itself is looking very good. Friedel is doing a good job, man. He's going up in his rating. He's only 25 years old. Hey, if you keep going up, I'll keep you. I will have to bring in a new center back, though. That is for sure. I was close to buying Dardai for 8 million. The centre-back talent from Hertha BSC, but then decided, you know what, nah, I'm just going to wait until he retires and then spend a big money on that centre-back spot because I'm pretty happy with the rest of the squad. I mean, Paulinho only a plus 2 this season, I believe. Agu has gone up nicely. Pavlenka is still viable for us. He's very good, only 31 years old, and I am assuming he had a good season this time around. And then when you look at the rest, like players like Varela, and also, where's the other lad? Where's the other Argentinian that I had? Did I get rid of him? Oh yeah, I put him into the deal, didn't I? Anyways, so Varela is down here as well as a decent backup for our squad, which I'm happy with. But man, that was a good season. Talking about good season, who scored the most goals for us? Werder Bremen back into European football. How crazy is that? Evan Nilsson, 16-2, plus 5 growth this year. That's exactly what I want to see. I want to see him at least at an 84 next year. Zakarian has had 13-3, which is decent. Fehrmann as a midfielder, as a center mid, 10-7. I'll take that. we have to consider this is against like much better teams than we played against last season. And Thuram's son is looking very good right now in that spot. And the French center attacking midfielder in Blas is disappointing me. I'll have to say, maybe he was injured. I'm not too sure what happened here. He only played 24 games. So yeah, hopefully that is going to sort itself out. It might be that this guy maybe pushes him out of position or something, but hey, we'll fix that next year. Schmidt is going to go. Blas is going to be the only center attacking midfielder viable for us. And let's see. We might have like a 50 million budget now. This is going to be good. Let's get ahead and spending. 8 million preseason, 50 million in the office, right? Right? Ah, come on. 38 only. That's a bit of a disappointment. Well, as you know, Toprak has retired and Schmid needs to go. And I've just seen our left back has gone up to an 80, which is good to see. But as mentioned, let's make those changes that we were thinking about. I want to bring in a left winger and change the formation to a 4-2-3-1 with wide players. So Schmid needs to go so that Blas also has the opportunity to like kind of blow up in that cam spot and do the thing that he's supposed to do, because Verman, our center midfielder, has had a better season scoring wise than he did, and that is not okay. I need him to step up his game. But Evan Nilsson was really good, man, last season. Very impressive. Now though, let's see what we can do with the money. I'll sell Schmid first, and then I'll buy the center back and the left wing. Let's get it on. Big change of plans. Someone just triggered the release clause of Evan Nilsson, which is Valencia. They're going to pay 62 million for him, and I can't extend this contract. So I need to find a new Brazilian striker. This is throwing my plans apart big time. So after selling Schmid and also Evan Nilsson, we're left with 103 million. Here's the issue though. I need to buy players from multiple positions now. I need a new striker that is Brazilian. I need a left wing. And I need a center back. This season is going to be a tough one. I only get to spend like 33 million for each player. 34 million, something like that. All right. Well, I'll try. I have just made a couple of amazing transfers. And one of them specifically you're going to be very happy about. Schlotterbeck, the Freiburg center back, the German, is coming into our team because I felt like I wanted to bring in another German into the squad. And here we go. He's 78 rated, valued at 19 million. I massively overpaid for him, but who cares? I'm not going to tell you how much I paid for him. Haha. Nah, I actually paid 30 mil. So I thought he's grown more, but he wasn't. But it's okay. It's okay. It's worth it, right? He comes at the same rating as Friedl, and Schlotterbeck is actually class. So Freiburg has had some really, really good success with him lately. And the team itself has been doing really well. So I'm very happy about that. Then I also brought in the other Thuram. Yes, Lilian Thuram doesn't have to watch a couple of games to see both of his sons play now. He just has to watch one game and one game only. Thuram on the left wing, Thuram in the CDM. There we go. We have brought them back together. And then I don't think I've spent any more money. I think I brought in a center. Oh, sorry. Caio Jorge. Yes, we have brought in a new Brazilian striker. I was thinking I bought someone else. I forgot. I brought him from Juventus. 75 rated. Obviously, way lower rated than Evan Nilsson. But I had to spread out the money the proper way to be able to bring in someone into that striker position that was kind of good, but not insanely overpriced. At first, I was thinking about the Watford striker. What was his name? I don't even know. João Pedro or something? I don't know. I'm not too sure on it. Anyways, he was at Girona. He has a release clause of like 50 mil, which I was not really ready to pay. So I went for the cheaper option. We're going to build up Caio Jorge here, and hopefully he will be the new Ailton for our squad. 6 foot tall, 21 years old, 80 pace, 74 shooting. Hopefully some nice potential on him. Ideally want to see him at a 79 or even 80 at the end of the season, which would be perfect. But entire squad should be, if possible, above 80 by the end of the year. But this man could hold it back. Now the team's set. Got no more money to spend. Only going to be dealing with the wages. Our second season in the Bundesliga. Let's see how it goes, lads. I hope for a very, very good year and Champions League football to bring in some good cash. And our Champions League journey is over already. But we are in the cup. We lost against Tottenham in the Champions League, and it's looking like a weird season. Is that the cup final now coming up? Are we in a cup final? I think we are. Hey, let's go. German cup final. But I'm not seeing the same type of consistency like we did last season. I'm seeing a lot of draws here. A lost against Wolfsburg. A lot of draws there. A couple of draws there. Against Tottenham, we only lost that Champions League battle by one goal. And we are now in the final of the German Cup, which is a good thing, don't get me wrong. And we will go ahead and simulate this one quickly for you guys to see if we can lift the first trophy off this Werder Bremen rebuild or not. I personally hope sure we can, and I hope that the team has grown enough. So let's take a look at it. We see Kaio George at a 79, nice, Blas 86, Zakaria 90, first 90 rated player in the team. The midfielders are looking very good. Thuram up to an 86, Paulinho continuing to grow, which is nice to see. Agu 85, Schlotterbeck and Friedel 82 and 81. Friedel, I don't think he's a talented player, but I think that last season must have done something to these players because we were fourth in the Bundesliga, and I think that was unexpected. So it must have been a good season and impacted their dynamic potential nicely. But here it goes now against Leverkusen in the cup final. Can we lift the first trophy off this rebuild? No, we cannot. It's a shame. It's a well and truly a shame here. We lose it despite Zakarian's efforts by Leverkusen take away the chance of the first trophy being lifted. Congratulations to them. Where did we end up in the Bundesliga? Please, top six. Ooh, okay. So top four last season, top six this season. But you know what? Any Werder Bremen fan would take that if I would offer them that right now. Because as you guys might not know, right now in the Bundesliga, Werder Bremen is in a terrible, terrible spot. In the second Bundesliga at the moment, Bremen is seventh. That's not good enough. I mean, you got to be up there. The good thing is it's only a couple of points until they get into the top three. But ideally, you want to get into the top two because then you don't have to play playoffs, which are epic. Every year, I watch those games when those happen, where the second Bundesliga third place team plays against the team that finished bad in the Bundesliga, but still has a chance to redeem themselves with just those playoff games. They are super intense and they tend to give you some of the craziest moments. I still remember Hamburg, for example, where the guy named Diaz, I think, scored a free kick in like one of the games to then save them. And so that Hamburg did not go down that year, but the year after, I think they went down. Anyways, it's crazy. But Leverkusen, top six, Conference League. We'll go with it. It's fine. Hopefully, though, I can see us do well in that Conference League. And I need to see us do better in the season as well. I mean, if you look at the league table, we have how many points? 59 points. It's not too far away from Bayern Munich and Dortmund there, man. We could have easily made it into the top three, in my opinion, but somehow slipped up in the first half of the season. Things have not necessarily gone too well. And I do put it down to having a low-rated striker now. Thuram has done exceptionally well. 24 goals, 6 assists. Let's go. Kaio, as you can see, only 12 goals. I can't blame the kid, you know. You can't really blame him. A 6.7 average rating. Hopefully, he can still get to at least an 82 next year. And until we have insane money and buy like someone like a Gabriel Jesus, I think we're just going to trust this kid and see how he does. Blas has done better this season, so that's good. Fairman, not as good as last year, but still very, very impressive. And then some substitutions have done well. Zakaria only with 5 and 8. That's a bit of a letdown considering you're 90 rated, pal. Something must be wrong with the tactics. I'm going to change the tactics for the next season. We go into the new season with my headphones not working, and now they're working. We go into the new season, guys, and we have how much money? 65 mil. That's a good budget, man, considering that we only came sixth. That's a really good budget. Where do I make the changes? I hate this international sign where I can't see the players' ratings. Maybe I change Friedel. Maybe he has gone to his full potential now. He's not necessarily going to be going up much higher. I mean, 65 mil is a lot of money. And I feel like the defense might be the reason as to why we suck so bad. Or maybe I go ahead and get myself a new goalkeeper that's higher rated and just spend it all on that. You know what? I think that might be the way. New center back, new goalkeeper, possibly. Let's see what I can work out. Well, your boy has pulled off some wonders. Sales have come in, and they have come in at decent prices. Somehow I've sold Friedel, who is going for 26 million for 42. Pavlenka, who goes for 21 million, I've sold for 35. I should be sued as a scam artist, but that right there gives us 131 million to spend. Well, let's get it on, guys. Now it's the time. New center back, new goalkeeper, And they can be quite high rated right here. Two deals.
Yes, two deals where that was the number that we wanted to go for. And now we got it done. Salisu signs as a center back. I watched him play for Southampton, I believe it is, in the last game week. And he was absolutely awful. But we're going to try him out in this career mode now. 81 rated, 32 million. I had to pay 42 million for him, I believe. Let me just double check right here. 43.4, and the big signing himself, Gregor Kobel, I think he's from Switzerland, if I'm not mistaken. Nonetheless, he is coming in, the Dortmund goalkeeper, for 67.5 mil. So Pavlenka has been replaced nicely, and also a new centre-back joins us in Salisu, and the squad size has been shrunk down because we had way too many players here that had no point of being here. So we finally fixed all of that. And now our team is actually looking somewhat okay. It's not great, don't get me wrong, but it is looking somewhat okay in terms of depth. That's what I'm talking about. The starting lineup now looks better than ever before, and I'm ready to take on this season. A top four finish is a must, in my opinion. After the signings, and we are now in possibly the finals of the Europa League, I think, right? Right? No, we're not there yet. Now we might be getting in there. In May. Oh, no. Come on. We lost it against Lazio. Okay, so we didn't make it to the Europa League final. But what I'm seeing here is that we have beaten Bayern Munich. I'm seeing that we have beaten teams like Ajax, Leipzig, Gladbach. We have won the league, haven't we? Dortmund is the only team we lost against. Ah, no. We started off bad, though. No. It's a good season. It's a good season. Come on. Dortmund beat us twice. They might be the only team that might hold us back from winning this. Werder Bremen for the championship. Yes, we have
done it for the first time. Werder Bremen is back at the top.
Yes, last time this happened, it was the 2003-2004 season. And now we have finally done it, guys. A big dub. And of course, it's not the end of the journey. We still have a long way to go. We still want to win the Champions League. And for that to happen, we do need a much better team. We couldn't even get to the final of the Europa League, which is obviously a big indication of how our team is currently in terms of their ability. Now, 82 points, a huge gap over Dortmund. That showcases us that we might be ready to dominate the Bundesliga for a couple of years. And I do appreciate that. Who are the top scorers? Who's doing well? Ooh, I'm seeing 90s. Nice. We see Zakaria, 92. Beautiful. Thuram with a +3 in this season, 27 years old. Blas, same age, 89. Kobel, +2. Agu has gone up nicely. Thuram with a +3. Let's go. Both of them lads are doing well. Schlotterbeck, big dub. Nice signing. Paulinho with the +2. Salisu, +3. That was important. Caio Jorge, +5. Massive growth for the Brazilian. Maybe he is well and truly Ailton. Who scored the most goals? Thuram, 28 in 10. Wow, great season for him. Caio, 17 in 1. I accept that. And I do think he's going to get to like at least an 87 next year, which is huge. Double digits for Blas on goals and assists. Perfect. Zakarian this time around holding himself back a little bit though, but that is completely fine. Our CDM Thuram actually got 7 assists. Well done, buddy. That is a very, very good season. Now back into the Champions League, and we should be getting a massive amount of money, which I probably should be spending. Hold on. Fährmann's gone. Oh no. Someone bought Fährmann. I don't want him to go. I'm going to buy him back. I was very happy with him. Who the hell bought my Fährmann? Joey Fährmann, I want to get you back. Man City bought you. I have 148 million. Let's make this happen, please. Man City, give him back to me. What the hell happened there? I hate when that happens. 145 million I just had to pay to bring him back. He's going to be back next season. Disgrace. I'm very excited to see this budget here for Werder Bremen after becoming the champions. 75 mil, only a 10 million increase on what we had before. I find that to be a bit of a disgrace, to be honest with you. But hey, it is what it is. And only a day after, Fährmann should be back into the team. So that is going to be very important for us. Let's see if he's back. Schmidt, get out of here, bro. I don't need you in there. Where's Fährmann? There he is, 88 rated. That's the player that I wanted to have in that spot. He's ridiculous, by the way. Really, really decent stats there. The centre-back positions are the only ones where I'm like, yeah, do I need to change things here or not? I mean, I trust Kyle George. I'm sure he's low-rated, but I don't want to change it. I really don't want to change it. And if I have 75 million to spend, where do I spend it? That's the big question. It's either left-back, centre-back. Yeah, those two positions. Nothing else. Paulinho, how old are you now? He's 30. Ooh. Okay. You know what? It might be the left-back. Let's go ahead and buy a new left back. This is the deal I needed. Nuno Mendes coming in. 120k in his wages at Leicester. He's going to get 67k in our club. A disgrace that he doesn't have a real face on this game yet. But Mr. Ailton has signed him just now. And of course, this guy is one of the highest potential left backs in the game. Those are the types of players that really can only improve our team at this stage. That's what happens when you get further into career modes. I'm fully aware he has the same rating, but he is 23 years old. So we have a lot of upside to Mensch, while Paulinho at the age of 30, probably not anymore. So very happy with that signing. He was supposed to be an insane player. Hasn't really had that insane season at PSG yet. So if things don't work out for him, I can easily see PSG go out there and buy Theo Hernandez from AC Milan because he's French as well. So I could see that happen to bring in someone that is going to bomb up and down that left-hand side for PSG. But yeah, this guy is a big talent. Hopefully it works out for him. There is no way. We got past Real Madrid in March 2026. Is this actually going to be the season after Real Madrid, Man City? These are some big names. We're through Juventus in the semi-finals. I never played against Juventus in the semi-finals, and we start off with a win and we get it done. We get it done. Werder Bremen in 2026. We have made it to the Champions League final. Let's take a look at the team that has done it. I'm actually really hyped about this moment right here, guys. Ooh, okay. Kaio George up to an 88. Five-star Brazilian with really good pace. Amazing dribbling. Great shooting. That's Ailton-like right there. Blas coming in with the 91 rating. Turan, 92. Zakarian up to a 93. The other Turan brother, close to the 90, but not there yet. Fehmarn up to an 89. Salisu and Schlotterbeck both up to an 89. Mensch has got up to an 89. Beautiful growth through the development plan glitch, as you guys know. Agu up to a 92 and Kobel up to a 91. This team is very much worthy of a Champions League final. Let's be real with each other. Starting lineup is ridiculous. The reserves here, or the bench, is more like a Bundesliga 2 team. But hey, let's not talk about that. Let's take a look into the stats of the players before we go into the Champions League final and enjoy ourselves. Kaio, 25 goal contributions. Turan with 30. Zakarian with 29 himself. Fehmarn 12 and 12. Very nicely done. Why is this guy never performing? I want to see if he performs for me when I play the game. That's where I'm going to see if he's actually decent or not, because he's currently the captain of the team. Do we have anyone from the original team? I think we do, right? Agu was the original player. So let's give him the captaincy. An original Werder Bremen player has made it to the Champions League final. All right, let's get it. Oh, hold on. Before we even forget about this, what happened in the Bundesliga? Third by 2 points. Really? Okay, Bayern and Dortmund and Bayern fifth and sixth. Yeah, this season was a mad one. We've scored the most goals, but we've conceded 40. That's not good, is it? I mean, we have the joint best goal difference, but just one game makes a difference. Too many draws for Werder Bremen, man. First half of the season must have not gone too well. Anyways, third place, that's fine. Give me that Champions League trophy. Yellow, no, yeah, not yellow. Green and white ribbons on both sides, please. Barcelona coming in with Ansu Fati, Chiesa, De Jong, Renato Sanchez, Koke, Savage, Koundé, Mazraoui. That's a good team. Well done, Barca. We have had some crazy Champions League finals lately. Hopefully, this one is not going to be one of them where I lose my mind. Miroslav Klose being pictured as the main man for Werder Bremen in this Champions League final. I'm ready to take this on. I hope we're going to have some fun. Let's move the camera into the top right so you guys can see everything. Here we go. I'm excited. Blas, are you actually good on the ball? Five-star skills. Okay, that's a good start. De Jong tries to take the ball away from him. Nope, not happening right now, pal. Go on then. Turam. I'm so happy that we have both the brothers in one team, by the way. That makes it feel even more important. We still have the ball here. I want to get a first shot off. Okay. Well, Barca defended well. Schlotterbeck, nice defense, pal. Move it. Nice. Control. Ooh, Blas is dribbling is really good. Here he goes. Here he goes. Well played, pal. Into Thuram. Thuram. What a save. Who the hell is that in goal for them? Testegen is still playing. GG's, pal. Oh, okay. Now he has to put in another tackle. Well played by Barca. Oh, wow. Whoa. Whew. Okay. Well played by Barcelona, man. This team is actually really good. This is scary. Down the right we go with Arsen Sakarian. One of the biggest talents to come out of Russia in a long, long time. Thuram at the far post. That's all you. What a goal. That's what you get from a tall, physical left winger. Lilian Thuram, I hope you're watching this. Your son just scored in the Champions League final. Come on. Massive. What a goal, man. Zakarian, the Russian beast, brings in the cross. And here we go. Thuram makes us take the lead now. Hopefully, we can carry on this great form here. I mean, Barcelona did have their chance. They do have some insane dribblers in here, so I gotta be careful. It's only one goal. Anything can happen. Oh, you know what? The fans are currently singing "Der SVW ist wieder da." That says in like translated from German to English. That says Werder Bremen is back again. That's a lovely song for a rebuild, and that's a great goal from Barcelona. Well, I should have probably not focused too much on the songs that the fans are singing. I mean, you can see in the background, they're not seeming too happy right there. Well, at least he didn't do a Rodri like he did against Arsenal, I believe it was, when Rodri scored, when he runs towards the Arsenal fans and like pretends like he's throwing his shirt at them. I don't know what the hell he was up to, but my God, he's lucky that he did not get punched up there. Go on. Nice. Great ball into Zakarian again. He's going to have a huge impact again, isn't he? Zakarian! Kyle George, how do you miss that? Brother, you need to be doing better there. I'm going to choose Salisu here to go for that cross. Salisu, Salisu, Salisu. Close enough. All right, that's a great ball. Chiesa now running down the wing. Chiesa does well. Oh, there we go. Mensch picks it up. Over into the center. Zakarian again with a great run down the right, but it is an even better pass coming in towards him. Zakarian, he is able to hold people off. I love that about him. Blas, don't pass it. No, there was a perfect opportunity to pass it to Thuram. His opponent just fell to the ground, bouncing off of him. That would have been great. Ooh, so close. Thuram misses the ball. De Jong now running through. Big tackle. Big, big tackle. That could have easily been 2-1 for Barcelona if we don't stop him right there. The first half is about to be done. Barca has an amazing amount of possession. And of course, they have some great, great dribblers in this squad as well, with pace and stuff. This is turning out to be a very tough Champions League final. This could easily go into the penalties. Oh God, this is not going to be good, is it? De Jong. Okay. Big, big save from Koble. He doesn't seem too tall, does he? He seems a bit short there, but it's fine. Why did it switch players? Come on. Move it away. Move it away. Well done. Well done. Here's Zakarian now. If I can do it right, if I can get past him here, this is going to be massive. Zakarian running down the wing. Thuram again in the center, just expecting a ball. He gets it nearly. He nearly pulls it off. I should have waited one more second. Wow, he actually kept that in. What a beast. That's now only a throw in. Thuram. He has an option next to him. He's going to just tank his way through. Thuram! Imagine if he can score from that tight angle. Well saved. I think, you know what? I think I'm going to go for Salisu again. He did get a chance the last time. Salisu. He's going to rise up. He rises and he doesn't do anything with it. That was an awful header. Might be able to get that easily. Well done. Come on. Agu, well done. Come on, captain. Man. Now we're open at the back. Now we are open. I don't like this. This is some great passing play from Barca. Big save. Here we go. Fährmann, can you shoot from outside the box? He nearly showcased perfect ability, but we're still chasing it. You know, with certain players, when they have the ball, you can feel they're 90 plus rated, or at least like 88 rated, right? But some players,
you're just like, wait, you're supposed to be 90 rated? Really? The amount of times that happens to me when I do these rebuilds is actually crazy. But so far, this team fully has been feeling really good. It's just that Bossa is actually nuts. They seem to have superpowers in these kits. Oh, please. What am I doing? What just happened? What the actual... I can't believe what I've just seen. Please, someone explain. Someone please explain to me what the hell just happened there. I get a perfect block in. My defender passes it back to Koble instead of passing it forward. And Koble gets his feet stuck in the goal. I mean, you have to be kidding. There's 20 minutes to save this. Come on, guys. We've had plenty of chances. Let's get a few more. At least one more big chance. 20 minutes, and here's the issue as well. If I had any substitutions, it would be perfect. It would be absolutely perfect to use them now, but I don't. And that is a problem. Did I just really run into my own player? I think I just did. Nah. Please, not like this. Not like this, Bossa. Oh my God, no. No. What a tackle. No. 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 That's it. We've lost it. We have actually lost it. Or have we? I don't know. I'm going to go. What's it called? Constant pressure. This is a situation that we never had before. If I can somehow pull this off, this is going to be one of the greatest comebacks that you've ever seen on this channel. Oh, come on, Turam. You got to be doing better than that. Hello, anyone here to help me? Kaio, I have not seen you do a thing yet. Kaio George plays it inside. We are moving. In numbers. Great ball into Blash. Can he finish this? She peels off the defender. Okay. 6 minutes. 6 minutes and a dream. Please. Please, please, please. Liverpool have done it against AC Milan. I want to do it against Barcelona. Please. Please. Zakarian. Some space. He hits the crossbar. No. No freaking way. Please get that. Oh my God. He actually hit the crossbar. Help me. Help me get the ball off of this man. Yes. The high pressure is working. Come on. Blash. No. 19th minute. This is crazy. This is absolutely crazy. Please, Agu. Please, Agu. No. I had the ball there. Yes. Yes. Move it. I see you, Turam. Turam. Yes! Oh my God! What a finish! What a moment! 3-3 in 90 plus 2! He couldn't have hit that ball better than he did in that position. That is the best Champions League moment we have ever had in any of the rebuilds so far. Turam. Oh my God, he scores his second! Come on! This is not over yet!
If you're wondering why I am scream, like whisper screaming, it's late and I don't want to piss off my neighbors. Now we go into extra time and look at this now, guys. The team has basically no stamina. So it's going to come down to good passing play. We've made it back here. Hold on. I need to change my tactics again. I'm like constant pressuring still. Yeah. Let's bring this back to balanced. Let's bring the depth down again. Let's not go too crazy. We gotta take it slow now. No rushing. Here goes Kaio George. Turam again. Oh, please. Turam. Oh, my God.
You're a god. This guy's a god. This guy just ruined the entire Barcelona squad by himself. I cannot believe what I'm seeing. A hat-trick in the Champions League final. I mean... Look, going into the Champions League final, the first couple of minutes, I thought it was all going to be about Blas and his five-star skill moves and his nice dribbling. But look at the way this man has taken over the show. Turam is the best left winger I have used. This is incredible.
Now, Koke is running down the right for them, obviously, not for us. For us, it's the left-hand side. Koke is getting past Nurmange a little bit too easily. Uh-oh. Please. Don't tell me that's a pen. Okay, it's not a pen. Nice, Turam. Well done. His brother is doing well there as well. Lovely. Now, Zakarian. I see that run. What a ball. Please beat him. No, he couldn't beat him. Kaio George still unavailable in this Champions League final. I mean, this whole thing was built around the center attacking midfielder and the striker, Ailton and Miku, but my God, these other players are dominating our game right now, and I don't mind. Please, Barca, don't do this to me now. I've done my best. I've done my absolute best, Barca. Don't take this away from me. Thuram, now our team is sitting back a little bit deeper, by the way I can tell here. Oh no. Oh no, no. Yes, well done. Good. Getting that ball back. Straight into the attack now. I see a run. That's a great ball from the Brazilian over to the Frenchman. The Ailton Miku partnership. Is it going to work out? I should have played it through. What the hell is he doing? That's going to be mine, isn't it? Thuram, easy dub against Renato Sanchez. He's not going to lose that, is he? That was a nice move, but well. Barca is still on it. There's a couple of minutes to be played here. Champions League final. Extra time is going to run out in a second. Can I achieve something here? That's a risky pass. That's a great ball. Over to Blas. He's going to get stopped. Kaya George and Blas putting on the pressure now on our opponents. We're going to try and hold them back in their half. There we go. Agu, as the captain, steps up. Werder Bremen, so close to winning the Champions League trophy. This is the moment. He plays it back. Huge mistake. Referee should be blowing the whistle. Yes. 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 The best Champions League final we have played. Unbelievable. We have won some Champions League finals in penalties. But man, that 90+2 goal, that will never be topped again. I might have to watch that goal again after this game, after I'm done recording this video, because that, my friends, was a beautiful moment. Something that I haven't had happen in a quite long time here in terms of like recording videos. That felt so good. When that flew in into the top right corner, if I didn't have neighbors, my God, I would have been very, very loud. Get in. Give me that trophy right now. Werder Bremen has done it. Again, I said I want to see that green and white on both sides of the trophy, and we have now pulled it off. Guys, a couple of players here are ridiculously good. Zakarian is a beast down the right. Thuram was unbelievable. Both of them. The CDM was very good as well. And Agu, the captain, the original of Werder Bremen, lifting that trophy at the end. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video until now, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe if you are new. And man, these videos are fun. Thank you for watching. Take care and peace.